Hey guys, I'm the Fallen Jedi and welcome back to another video. In today's video, I'll be ranking the maps in Star Wars Battlefront 2 from least to best map in my own opinion. This is a video that Battlefront Knight and many more YouTubers did, and I thought it would be a good video to do as the game is getting no new maps anymore. Remember, this is my opinion, so I know not everyone will not agree with me. I'll be basing the ranking from an overall map, not just a certain mode. I'll be only doing the 23 main maps. None of the Starfighter Assault maps because that game mode's dead. So make sure to let me know your favourite maps down below in this comment section below. Okay, let's dive into it. Coming in at last place is Jakku. I really hate this map with a passion. The design of the map I don't like and gameplay isn't good because you always have campers that snipe you, which is really annoying. It seems like that you can't get past the first phase when you play Galactic Assault. Also, whenever you want to play online, you always seem to end up on Jakku, which is annoying. I am not a fan of the new movies, which also helps Jakku come in last. Coming in at second last spot is Endor. Now, I know a lot of you guys love this map. Like, I like the design of the map, but to me, gameplay-wise, it's really bad. If you're on the Galactic Empire team, I feel like all the time, you cannot find a Rebel because they basically camouflage into the map. I prefer the 2015 Battlefront Endor one, but not this one. I always leave the game when I find Endor. Coming in third last is Starkiller Base. The reason why this map is above Endor is because I really like the design of the map, but I just don't enjoy games on it. The only intense and interesting phase is the last stage. I think the reinforcements are an awesome addition to the map, but I just don't enjoy playing on the map. Coming in at 20th is the Separatist Dreadnought. Now, I don't know if people will agree with me, but I find that the capital ships for the Age of Republic aren't the best for gameplay-wise. I only think it's fun to go into the capital ships if you are playing Supremacy. I'm just not a huge fan of playing it as a separate map. I only think the first phase is good, but then the others aren't as good. So that's just my opinion for it. I'm not too sure what you guys are going to think about it. But just overall, I don't know, it's just a bit plain. It's not as fun as on ground. But coming in at 19th, is the Republic Venator. Now, it is higher than the Separatist Dreadnought, only because I like the design better, but everything else is basically the same in the Separatist Dreadnought, so nothing really changed from there. Coming in at 18th is Kashyyyk. Now, I know some of you guys love this map, but personally, I find you have another problem with campers who snipe, and the design of the map is not good for gameplay for myself. This map I am not that good on and I do not enjoy it. I really don't like it when people have vehicles because they are so protected from like the bushes surrounding them and that they can kill you all the time very easily and they just harass you all the time, which is very annoying. I do enjoy the Heroes vs. Villains section, but since this is a different area, I don't like it. The only phase I like is the second phase when you go into the AT-AT. But I just think DICE should have copied the original Battlefront design where it was more on the beach. Coming in at 17th is Takodana. I would think that a lot of people would agree with me on this because it's really hard to get past the first phase if you are the First Order in Galactic Assault. I do think this is a below average map. I like the design, but I do think they have done a lot better with adding Supremacy to this map, which makes the map a bit more enjoyable, but just as an overall map, it doesn't really excite me. The last phase in Maz's castle is the only intense and fun part, I think. Coming in 16th is Hoth. Now, I do really like the design of the map, but it seems like you are only limited to two classes, which is Heavy and Specialist, when you are outside. When you go inside, into the second last and the last phase, then it opens up to what you can choose anything. But I think the time you are outside, you get harassed by vehicles and snipers. I was upset when there was no capture points inside Hoth for Supremacy, since it's all outside, but I'm just not a big fan of the map in general, but it looks nice. Coming in at 15th is the MC-85 Star Cruiser. I have the same feel about it like I did with the other capital ships, but there is only two things I like about it. It is the design of the map inside of the cruiser and how the map for the first few phases are quite close, so you can use your barrage and impact grenade with like a sentry gun to wipe out enemies, which is always fun. But that's it. For me, I do prefer the on-ground battles as you get more access to a variety of things. That's why I'm not a super fan of, like, you know, these ship maps. Coming in at 14th is Tatooine. Now, I really do like this map. I like the design of the huts. This is one of my favorite original trilogy maps. The only thing I don't like is the last phase. I think there's too many things in the way, and it's really hard to get kills because the Millennium Falcon's like right in the middle, and when you want to like shoot people, you know, they can always hide away, and it's very annoying. Also, another big issue is that for the AT-ST, I think this is one of the best maps to play on as an AT-ST because you can just legit torch everyone. A lot of AT-STs I find online, they just go to where the spawn point is and they just torch you out. I also think Boba Fett, this is his map. So if you come across a good Boba Fett, good luck. Coming in at 13th is Yavin 4. I like this map, but it's just not that exciting when you play it. It is just an average map. The gameplay is average. The design of the map is average. One thing I like about it is the second last stage when you are outside the temple. I think that is really fun phase to play as it opens up the map. And I just like how all the rebel ships are laid out everywhere. Coming in at 12th is the Jean Kloss. This is one of my favorite maps from the new trilogy as I really like the design of the map. I did like it a lot more, but now they have added in AI vehicles in co-op, which are so OP. The very last phase is super fun as it always is intense for myself and you can just throw all your grenades and lighten people out with your sentry gun. The one bad thing about the map, it's too big and it's hard to get to point to point. It just gets annoying because you don't want to be spending half the game running to checkpoint to another. Coming in at 11th is the Resurgent Class Star Destroyer. Now, I know I was saying before that I'm not a big fan of the capital ship maps, and a lot of people won't agree with me, but I really like the map because the design of it just looks amazing. I love the phases you do in the match, but the only thing I hate about it is the second phase, if you are the First Order, you are capturing a small section where everyone will be, and you you can get a really annoying BBA that just uses his cable spin and eliminates everyone. But the gameplay is average, but the design of the ship is really nice. Coming in at 10th place is Jabba's Palace. Now this map is a kill spree map if you spray everyone with your grenades and you use your CR2 or the TL50 just to spray everyone. I have nothing wrong with this map, I just don't get as much enjoyment as the other maps coming up in my ranking. The only thing I don't like about this map is the second last phase. You get people use Bossk and just deploy their mines everywhere and just torch you out with the Predator Instincts ability. But other than that, I think it's a very well-balanced map. Coming in at 9th is Bespin. Now, I'm sorry I could not get gameplay for this map because I haven't found a Bespin map forever. It is like impossible or like it doesn't even exist anymore to get a map. But I have loved this map over the years of Battlefront. It is one of my favorite maps from the original trilogy. I love the gameplay of the map. The only thing I don't like about this map is when you play Heroes vs. Villains and you get pushed off the edge a lot, which is annoying, but you have to read what the opposition is doing. I do wish they brought in the DLC of the Bespin from Battlefront to 2015 into this game, because the ground battle for it was amazing. Coming in at 8th is Felucia. Now this map came out not long ago, but it was a huge success when it did come out. We can all agree that Felucia is one of the most beautiful maps we have to date, due to the tone and balance we have. The detailed dice put into the map is incredible, and I'm still shocked of how amazing it looks. It is always fun when you are playing this map. I haven't got tired from this map like other maps, but the only reason why it's not as high is that I succeed on other maps more than Felucia. Coming in at 7th is Death Star 2. Now, I really like this map. The whole design of the map is amazing to look at, but as well, it's really fun to play on this map as you can definitely rack up the kills. The only thing is that I'm finding it a bit more boring the more times I play it, but the map is still very nice to play on and I still love playing on it. I'm always excited to get my barrage out and wipe out players. So coming in at 6 is Crait. Now I'm sure a lot of people can agree with me, but it wasn't this high until EA did their last update and gave us the new Crait Heroes of Villains map, which just blows my mind away when I see it. It definitely is a sniper battle when you play Galactic Assault, but a lot of people will go specialist anyway in the first phase when playing Galactic Assault. But the only downside of this is that it's impossible to find a map of Crait when playing Galactic Assault. So since it's rare, you should always be excited to play crate. I do love when you can use the crate speeders. I think that would be my favorite thing about gameplay wise. It's not as high because the other maps I like a lot better. So coming in at fifth is Geonosis. Now I know a lot of people like it or don't like it. Whereas for me, I love this map. It may seem like a pretty basic map to make, and there isn't as much detail into the map as other maps, but I still think that from this day, the Geonosis update is what brought back the game to life. And it was 100% the biggest update with the new mode, heroes like Obi-Wan Kenobi, General Grievous, the new reinforcements, new appearances. I personally love playing this map. I do find I don't do as good on Geonosis, but the main thing is that it's probably from my poor playing style. I think all phases are really good, and how Geonosis has basically two separate maps, one for Galactic Assault and one for Supremacy, it's just awesome. Coming in at fourth is Kessel. Now this is just one of DICE's best maps, I think, because of the detail shown in the map. It is a smaller map than the others, but the detail they're going into the surroundings with the smoky grounds at the bottom of the map near the edge, the inside of the mine, is just amazing to look at. And you'll always have hectic battles for every phase. I think what they did with co-op by getting rid of the Millennium Falcon outside was a really good idea to open up the map to make it a bit more interesting. Now coming in at third is Scarif. Now I'm not just saying that just because it's a new map, but I'm sure that everyone would have at least Scarif in their top five. The map is amazing. The detail into the map with the smashed AT-AT and the smashed X-Wing in the middle of the map, the different landing bays you can see, the cargo AT-AT that's walking in the water in the background, and obviously the beautifulness of the Imperial Security Building. I love both sunset and daytime for this map. Gameplay wise is super fun, as you can play as Shore Troopers now, which is awesome. Coming in at second place is Kamino. This was very close with Scarif, but I think as gameplay wise, I just have as more fun and success on this map. I'm not a huge fan of the first phase when you play Galactic Assault, but the other phases in the clone facility and the outside area is amazing. I love the whole texture and the design of this map. Also, one great thing about this map is it doesn't have as much snipers, so it limits that camping area. But also, Clone Wars is my favorite era, so obviously it helps Kamino being up there in the top. So coming in at number one is The Great Naboo. Now I know this is a fan favorite, and how can it be? I love this map to bits. This has been my favorite map since launch and has not changed. I love the palace battle scenarios and the different phases you do. The design and the detail on the map is amazing. It always is a joy to play on this map. What probably gives this map a big boost is it was one of the playable maps you could play in the Battlefront 2 beta. I thought the map looked amazing, because since I just transferred from 2015 Battlefront to 2017 and I didn't think the graphics could change, I was mind blown of how good Naboo looked. So that's going to end it for me. Yes, I know the explanations were a bit short, but I just wanted to give a quick overview of my thoughts on all these maps. Let me know your thoughts down below of my ranking in the comment section below, and let me know if you would like to see more ranking videos for Star Wars Battlefront 2. Make sure if you haven't already yet to subscribe, like, turn on that bell notification of when I live stream or when a new video comes out. I will not only be doing just Battlefront stuff, but mainly Star Wars things. Thanks for watching. As always, may the Force be with you always.